Mark Walker caught up with AJ Wood to preview the forthcoming Rugby World Cup. Here is his report.
So I'm here, back here with AJ Wood, and we're going to be discussing the forthcoming Rugby World Cup, which is in Japan.
Absolutely, yeah.
Great country, you've been there, so that's going to be great for anyone that's actually going to be watching
for sure,
England
yeah.
and the other side. But let's talk about the action. I mean, what's the tournament, what's it all about?
It's basically similar to the Football World Cup, similar kind of thing. There's group stages at the beginning, and then depending on how they get on and how they progress, then they move through to... obviously quarterfinals, semi-finals, final.
How many sides?
I think there's 32.
32 sides. And do we know the group? We know the groups they've been...
Yeah, so England have got Tonga and USA in their group, which should be relatively simple.
Should be. Tonga are all right, though, aren't they?
Tonga are these kind of minnows that teams can slip up against. And I England do need to win those two games. If they win those two games, then they... the draw completely opens up for them. They can face Argentina or France in the last 32. Last 16, sorry, followed by Australia, who are still ranked below them. They're ranked sixth in the world. Australia and England are third in the world in the last eight.
Yeah.
But they can meet New Zealand in the semis if that's the way, if that's the route they take, if they win both their games.
Yeah.
But they could meet New Zealand earlier on in the tournament if they were to lose one of them and win one of them.
So each team play, they play the others and they play once, right?
There's a group of three with
two games.
Absolutely.
So everyone's guaranteed two games. I mean, Tonga, I seem to remember in the rugby sevens in the Olympics for years ago, Tonga played England, I seem to remember, and they were all right.
They have some very, a lot of physical players.
They're
but they
very
also have
physical,
a lot. Also have a lot of... like quite a few pacey players that can on any day can get teams to slip up. Eddie Jones though in Japan, he knows Japan very well. His pedigree and his experience over there is amazing. He will definitely have England in the best facilities.
As
he said, and he knows Japan off the back of his thing, off the back of his palm. England have had a bit of a weird way to get to Japan. There's been typhoons in Tokyo, so they've had a delay at a nearby airport to catch their flight to Tokyo. They've had about 6 hours delay there, which isn't great preparation, but there's plenty of time. Their first game against Tonga is actually on the 22nd of September.
Yeah.
The opening game, which hosts Japan. Versus Russia, they play on the 20th, so still a while to go, but preparation is well underway. England have done very well, actually. They've beaten the world number one side, Ireland. They hammered them, really, but they scored 8 tries against them, which is a great effort.
Yeah.
They've played Wales in Wales, lost that one, but beat Wales at Twickenham. And they also, just before they went, they played Italy in Newcastle, and won quite convincingly there.
So it's looking good in the
absolutely,
in
the form's really good. It's just we know what England can do in big tournaments. Yeah, absolutely. In big tournaments, we hype them up and hype them up, and sometimes they let us down. Well, not let us down, but sometimes they don't perform to how they think they should perform as well as the fans should. Think.
Yeah. So just a word on Japan then. I mean, they obviously they had a good result. Was it South Africa?
Yeah, they beat South Africa at the Amex Stadium in 2015. That kind of reinvigorated Japanese rugby. That, like, Eddie Jones was the coach then. He's now the coach of England.
Yeah.
And it really did almost put Japan on the map, that kind of performance.
Yeah.
And I think they'll just go from strength to strength, and in their own conditions, they could upset anyone, really.
Yeah. Who else should we be looking out for before we go?
Ireland, for sure.
They're
the flying team at the moment. They're top of the world rankings. Never rule out New Zealand in a big tournament.
Yeah.
They turn up when they need to, basically. They're solid.
Australia.
Yeah, Australia, always. But I think England really do stand a chance. They're currently third in the world rankings. They're in decent form. They've beaten the world number one team. It's just whether they can... withstand it in big games and under big pressure in the world stage.
Yeah, and we're going to get some funny times, are we, for the matches then?
I think England's first game's at 11:15 GMT, so it's not actually that bad.
Yeah.
But in the morning, sorry, should I say. But I think, yeah, I think some of them will be very early in the morning.
I was going to say,
Yeah,
great country though, Japan.
Absolutely, so, I think there's a lot of fun. I think it's quite cheap, so I've been told. So I think the fans will make the most of their alcohol consumption, etc. over there.
Yeah, all right, we'll leave it there for now, AJ.
Thank you.
And we'll be speaking to you about the World Cup as it progresses.
Of course.
Cheers, thanks.
Cheers.